One of the things that I carry with me at all times when I'm on the set is I have 90% or above alcohol, which is like from an apothecary, surgical alcohol, because even if you have thick edges like what's on some of these prosthetics, you can thin them by using that alcohol to distress the edges enough that it thins them out and you have a little bit better blending. And that's really the key, is that in order to avoid the edges being detected on the high definition cameras, is to have those transparent edges. Very important. I'm so used to American students being so rude, they're always talking in my class, so this is like, am I doing something wrong? I'm allowing this to get tacky. Let's see. See? Now, this isn't sufficient for...
Hi, Debbie.
This is my husband, Reggie Bannister. It is not sufficient, especially on high definition, to simply color this like all one color. You have to create depth, because high definition cameras will flatten everything out, okay? So you have to trick it by realizing high definition works a lot like 3D. You have a cooler color to the rear to make it fall away. Your cooler colors are like purple, black, blue, like that. It causes them to fall away. Put the red, the yellow. Yellow is actually a medium color as opposed to our light spectrum, because in a light spectrum, yellow would be a hotter color, meaning brighter, right? But in high definition cameras, red, orange, like that, that is the hot color. The hot color goes closest to the camera, okay? Finish that one in a second.
Okay.
number one thing I worry about in doing someone's face is their reaction, their skin's reaction to the chemicals that I'm using. Number one rule is, if that actor tells you it is burning, it's burning. Take it off. Find out what's going on with it. The worst thing in the world that you can do is to ruin an actor's face accidentally. What you do to him on purpose is one thing. I very much like my work. Now, one cool thing about like using something like the fake skin is you can embed things into it, such as teeth, pieces of wood that's been painted to look like painted to look like bone. Okay. I don't use animal products other than gelatin. So when it comes to things like doing intestines, I use pantyhose, not sausage casings, and not real intestines or body organs. Because you have to, I mean, we're vegetarian, but you have to think in terms of, is that person going to react to bacteria that develops in meat? One of my horror stories is that I actually have heard of young men, and it's been suggested to me by young men, to use that they wanted to use real organs in a zombie film. I have two words in response to that. Mad cow. Not good.